ready for Australia's cheapest game show. One of our contestants will win $5 Australian as we play Studio 10's The $5 Quiz. Now, please welcome your quizmaster, David Robinson.
Hello there, everyone, and welcome to the $5 Quiz. My name is David Robinson. It's great to have your company this morning. Now, let's welcome the gal with the cash and the looks to match. It's Celestina, everyone. Hello there, you beautiful woman. Good to see you. It's been a while, hasn't it?
It has been a while.
But we're excited to give away a massive cash jackpot of $5. That's right. Let's meet our contestants now. We've got Sarah, Joe, and Joe.
Hi.
Lovely to see you. And we've got the lovely Bonnie, we've got Craig, and we've got Les there. Welcome to you. Let's get straight into it right now. Now, in celebration of World Chocolate Day, we have a quiz drizzled in just a little chocolate because I don't know which one I'm looking at, because we're not overindulgent here at Studio 10, so we're just having a little bit, that's all we're doing. Now, all right, panel, hands off your chocolate bars and on your buzzers, okay? It's been a stressful time getting ready for this quiz, let me tell you that for free.
Hey, all right. Robert, excuse me, you look at the camera where the red light is flashing.
Oh, okay, oh yeah, all right. Daddy's been a bit busy at the back. Trying to get ready for this quiz. This sequin doesn't put on itself, does it? All right.
Question.
Try and do it. Who wrote Charlie in the Chocolate Factory? Yes, Joe.
Roald Dahl.
Correct to you. Where did chocolate originate from? Sarah Harris?
Belgium.
I'm going to say Central America is actually where true. Yeah.
I was going to say from my tongue.
What?
True or false, milk chocolate isn't actually chocolate. Yes, Bonnie.
It's not actually chocolate.
It's true. Milk chocolate is. Yeah, that's all right. All right, we're going to play a new game here right now. It's called.
On the chocolate theme?
No, we're leaving that. This is a train wreck, so why not stop now? This train is going full speed ahead here on Studio 10. And this is great because it's just a rehearsal. The new game is called Hit the Pipe.
Have you done that this morning?
Oh, yeah. Daddy needs some medicine, and it comes in the shape of a Sauvignon Blanc bottle. But before we get to that, it's called Hit the Pipe, where we're going to play you some hit songs that are played by panpipes. And you've got to tell me what the song is for Hit the Pipe, a brand new song, brand new game here on the $5 Quiz. First song.
Enya.
Yes, Craig?
It's Roberta Flack killing me softly.
Correct to you, Craig. Well, nice one. Very nice. All right, next one in Hit the Pipe is this song. What's this song? Hit the Pipe, Pen Pipes. Yes, Joe Casamento. Yeah, what's the name of the song, though?
Celine Dion.
Name of the song?
My Heart Will Go On.
Correct. Nice work. We're having fun with Hit the Pipe. The last one for Hit the Pipe is this track. Yes, Joe Casamento. What is it, Joe Casamento? Yes. We got there again. Well done. Nice point there.
You knew that, Les.
Alrighty, time to play a classic of the $5 quiz. It's Slap in the Face now, everyone. But we showed you a face. You've got to tell me who it is. Alrighty, who is this face right now? Who are we looking at here? That's a toughie.
Amanda Keller.
Correct. To John Kessler. Wow. You are good. On the Living Room tonight on Network 10. Make sure you check it out. Who's this person?
Oh, Shelley Craft.
Incorrect there on that one. It's a bit spooky, this one, if you get my drift. Yes.
Gillian Anderson.
Gillian Anderson is correct. One half the X-Files there. Nice work. Next one for Slap in the Face. Who is this person?
Sugar, that's Michael Caine.
Michael something.
Les. I'm going to give you a point to Les. Caine is correct. Well done. The next one here, he's making a few headlines around the world. Who's this guy? Yes, Joe. I've got a ballistic missile and it's got your name on it.
Is that Kim Jong-un?
That's correct. There we go. Well done, Kim Jong-un. Wow, isn't he cute?
He's really aged well. I thought it was Justin Bieber for a while.
Same haircut. And the final one, the fourth slap in the face is this. Who is this person? Who is that? Yes.
It's the Milky Bar kid.
Correct. It is. Well done. Nice work. All right. Let's get a quick check of those.
Chocolate questions.
No. Well, that was the last one. Let's get a quick check of the scores now. We've got Sarah on one, Joe on two, Josie on three, Bonnie on zero, Craig on two, Les on one. It's anyone's game. We are going to put 60 seconds on the fast money clock, and your time starts Now, what came first, the Snickers or the Mars bar? Yes, Joe Casamento.
Snickers.
Snickers was in 1930, correct. Which country was Darrell Lee chocolate originated in? Yes, Karen.
Yes, Australia.
Correct. You're correct, that is right. What country claims their products is by the bald man? What company, sorry? What company? It's Max Brenner. I didn't like that question either. The band the band Hot Chocolate had a hit in three decades with... Yes, Sarah.
I believe in miracles.
Oh, you sexy thing, fine. I'll take it, yep. What country is the G20 summit happening? Yes, Joe Casamento. Correct. How many times has Elton John been married? Joe Casamento.
Twice.
Correct. Like, 20 seconds to go. Which TV network in Australia first aired Seinfeld? Joe?
Hildebrand.
Correct. What is the world's biggest ocean with six... Yes, Joe.
Pacific.
Correct. With 10 seconds to go. What is the flavour of Kahlua? Yes, Sarah.
Coffee.
Correct to you. What do you call a dot above the I or the J? Yes, Sarah.
Funny thing?
Yes, Craig, do you know it?
Yes, I do, and my tongue's just... I'm medicated.
It is, in fact, a tittle.
That's what it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Joe Casamento. Well done to you.
Thank you for
the bus there. You're going to buy, what are you going to buy? A bus ticket with that, right?
Send my Opal card. Thank
yes,
you.
That's
top
right.
up.
Now, Les, you're a massive star. What was the $5 quiz like for you?
That was an experience I'll never forget.
And that's usually what it is. Yeah. Thank you so much for playing, Les. Thank you, Craig. Thank you, buddy. Thank you, everyone. And thank you for playing at home.
Thank you.